Hey guys, this is coreWeaver. I just remember that I didn't back up my data for quite some time. If you have an optical drive sitting in an older computer, you don't use the computer anymore, but you still want to use the Blu-ray or the DVD drive, you're going to need an adapter or even better, a case, which will enable you to transform the drive into an external portable device. So stick around to find out how to build one yourself. You won't need any expensive tools for this project. The materials cost about 20 bucks and all the plans are going to be available for free. If you like to build stuff, you're going to love this project. Let's do this. When it comes to backup, I have two lines of defense. I use an external hard drive to make a copy of the most important files I want to keep. I do this almost once per month, and then two or three times per year I burn a Blu-ray disc with everything on that external hard drive. The reason I use Blu-ray discs instead of hard drives, SSDs, USB pen drives, or even SD cards is because a Blu-ray disc offers the best data retention. So in my case, I use a Blu-ray recorder. It's a 5.25 inches for internal base, and it was sitting in an older desktop computer, which I'm not using very often anymore. So doing a backup was becoming a pain. I started to look for a case for 5.25 inches optical drives, and I couldn't believe the price they sell for. So I decided to design and build my own external Blu-ray drive. I started modeling the whole thing first. Then I bought a few things like the 3mm MDF sheets and the aluminum profiles. Then I 3D printed some parts, and I also bought the USB to SATA adapter, which is the most expensive part for this project. You'll need a powered adapter because this drive draws like 1.5 amps at 5 volts and also 2 amps at 12 volts. And there's no way you can supply that directly from the USB port. The list with all the materials you're gonna need, the plans and the STL files for the 3D printed parts, it's all gonna be available in the description of this video. So the reason I used MDF for this project is that it's very easy to work with. I used a simple cutter to cut all the sides from a sheet of coated MDF. Just mark the lines, then using a ruler to guide the blade, just follow the line, and after a few passes the piece would just snap. And I sanded the edges. As you can see, the results are pretty good. After I finished cutting and sanding all the MDF pieces, I then started to work on the aluminum profiles. This will reinforce the whole thing, giving it a better structural integrity, and will make everything look much better. There are some 45 degrees angle cuts. I did all these cuts manually using a handsaw, and then I sanded everything till I got them to fit perfectly together. The next step was to tap these aluminum edges together. I did this because I wanted to paint everything at once so that the cutting line between these profiles will not be visible anymore. The next step was to start painting. I used a few coats of high gloss paint, and then I started to work on the 3D printed parts. Here's the front mask for the optical drive. You can see that it's made out of two parts. The size of the whole part exceeded my 3D printer's maximum printing volume, so I printed the two separate halves and then I glue them together and then spray painted everything. After that, I started to assemble everything. Here I'm making the bottom side of the case. I glued the MDF bottom piece to the aluminum profile, which forms the edge of the case, applied pressure, and then I let it like this a few hours. And I also placed these two metal plates on the bottom, and this will act like a guide for the Blu-ray drive. And I didn't want the drive to sit directly on the MDF. Then I started to drill the holes for the screws, which will hold the drive in place. I actually made 8 holes on the aluminum sides, but only four of them are needed, two on each side. You'll see why in the end. Everything was starting to take shape and I moved to the next step. I'm preparing to glue the back side and the lateral sides of the case. There's a very small clearance between these parts, so everything had to be very carefully assembled. I only used four screws for this case. They hold everything together. The bottom side of the case, the top side which is removable, the front mask and the optical drives which are obviously also removable. I should have been a little bit more careful with the amount of glue. I used a little bit too much and it's visible here. Marking the holes on the MDF lateral sides, I do this before gluing them. And then I drill the four holes, two on each side. And then I finally start to glue the back side and then the left and the right side of the case. All this time I'm keeping the drive and the 3D printed spacers in place just to make sure that everything is well aligned. I also use the front cover for the same purpose. It's applying pressure from the inside and keeps everything tight together till the glue will dry. This is the supporting part which sits underneath the USB converter. And I started the same process for the top side of the case. One of the last steps was to print and paint the letters which will form the logo I'm putting on the case. It's something that gives an extra touch to the whole thing. I think it looks great, and the name that I gave this case and actually the Blu-ray that sits in it, it's the X Drive. I printed all letters in 1mm height, painted them and then assembled everything together. You can see here, I used a photo exported from this SketchUp. So basically in the end, everything looks exactly how I modeled it in the beginning. The last thing I did was to plug in the SATA to USB converter. Slide the drive in the case. And then mounting the four screws. I'm using these last 3D printed parts for this, so the screws will not scratch the paint on the MDF sides. These parts are also hiding some small imperfections and they kind of give the case the last missing touch. It's time to test it now, and I'm applying power to the USB adapter, and then I plug the USB cable in my laptop. And as a cherry on top of everything, I changed the drive letter for this unit. I used the letter X. I changed it to match its name. I didn't need to install any drivers for this SATA converter. I'm on Windows 10 here, as you can see, but I also tested this on other operating systems. Just plugged in the USB cable and you're good to go. So in the end, I was really pleased with the result, especially when you do this using your hands. You don't have so many tools. You're very proud of every small detail. You're also very upset about every little mishap, you know, little imperfections. Fortunately, there's only one single spot. There's a small area, 2 or 3 millimeter wide, where the glue reacted with the paint on the NDF, and I will have to use a small tip paintbrush and clean that area. But other than that, everything looks gorgeous. I'm very pleased how it came out. It took a little bit of time and effort, but it was worthy. So I guess the question is, would I sell this for 58 bucks? Or would I trade it for some other case that you can buy on Amazon? No way. It's my own design and I love it. And I'm gonna remember how I built it each time I'm gonna use it. I just copied a few large files from an older backup disk just to test to make sure that everything works perfectly. And it does. Thanks for watching.